gonna go, me and Grandpa are gonna leg it.
Time recently for Alton Towers, and I thought today it'd be nice for us to come here and focus on the positives and what an amazing place this really is. A quality B&M inverted coaster Nemesis. Standing here since 1994 and still thrilling riders to this day. Obviously it's my local park and we are very, very lucky to have this still here. It's a great park, it's a great ride. Of course, you've got some other fantastic rides here, Oblivion, 13, Rita Spinball, some fantastic coasters so close. And I think after recent events, it's nice to come back to the park and sort of a nice summer's day, look around the park, get some nice ride shots, and have a fantastic day out. So what is the country's number one theme park? Jack's here.
Hey.
Lee's here.
Yeah.
Hey up. Alex, I believe he's on his way up. Well, I thought we'll come up for Alton Towers, just have a nice day. I mean, this is a quality ride. I think sometimes when we go to all these different parks, it overshots the fact that 7 miles up the road is what is still rated one of the best roller coasters out there. I mean, look at it. What other ride out there can say it was dug down into a huge pit like this? What a beauty. And it's also a nice quiet day for riding. So we're having a look around the park today, looking at some of the different changes, what are going on, and of course get some nice ride shots for you, just so we can all sort of see. We've been to a lot of different parks this year. We've only done one vlog this year from Alton Towers in the main season. I thought let's come and have a look around the park, because it is beautiful, Alton Towers. I think sometimes when you go to all these different parks, you know, you need to appreciate your home park a lot more. Do you agree?
I agree.
It's nice, you know, it's nice to be back here at the home park. And of course, Nemi's sat there waiting to ride. What a beauty. One of the most intense rides I've ever been on. Oh, you're giving Nemi a little rub down there, right? You know, we might have been to all these different parks, especially the past couple of years here on TPW, but when you do come off Nemesis, it still gives you that wow factor that it used to. I mean, do you agree though?
It's a beast.
You know, there's just something about that ride, especially when you're coming out of the loop. You know, you just think, wow, what a ride I'm on.
It's just so well, the layout is so
beautiful,
well
isn't it?
Together.
I mean, you know, yeah, hundreds of rides, hundreds of different roller coasters, but
it's the most, you know, it's the unique invert.
It's just
as well.
Beautiful, the way it sits there and the way the trees have grown up over the years.
It used to be so barren, you know, when it
opened. It did, you know, barren 1898, yeah. next week. That's going to be another ride. I love my experienced coasters. And barren, Akin. It's going to be a brilliant ride.
The best theming as well, looks like.
The theming, it's got to be one of the best theme B&M coasters out there, if not the best. It's
all
the only one.
Off our classic here, Oblivion.
It is. At the end of the day, if Oblivion wasn't built, then we wouldn't have had all the bigger versions.
It's like saying with Tatsu at Six Flags, which Sean will be riding very soon.
Yeah, a flying coaster that I'll probably ride. Well, you'll ride.
I think you'll probably like it more than the other two that he's ridden.
I'll get the credit.
Manta, I think he enjoyed. I'm not sure.
Yeah, Manta was all right.
It's intense, though.
It was quite intense, but it's supposed to be even worse, isn't it? The pretzel loop.
It's the tallest, longest and fastest that you're going to be riding
there. You go. But it's quality B&M coaster, you know.
All
so I'll be getting
classics.
The credit, yeah. you know, it's nice Alton over the years. We have had some firsts here. And, you know, when you think of all the records and the firsts that we've had, it's a great part to live local to. And I've not been as much this year, so I think it's nice today. We're going to do all the classics. Lee's not seen the new Ice Age film. Oh, God.
How are we doing?
There he is. He's just casually coming in from the back there. You all right?
Coming in with the monorail.
How are you?
All right, yeah, good, not bad.
Alex Crump, everybody. You missed out on Rise on Nemi.
Oh, I know, well, catch up later.
Catch up later on the beauty. So, yeah, we're just saying, we haven't been for a while to Towers.
We haven't been for a while.
It's nice to have you know, all these different parks we go to across the world. It's nice to come to our local and appreciate what we've got.
But it is very quiet today, which is good for riding. So Alex is going to have plenty of riding.
If you ever want to come on a quiet day, come on a Sunday.
It is Sunday today and it is a quiet day. Let's go. Akin Akinen. As you know, Alex loves ice cream.
Do I?
He likes any type of food, don't you, really?
Well, that's debatable, that.
Nitrogeni. Is that how you say it?
Nitrogeni.
Trademarks. Ice cream from Magic. I don't know how that's going to work. But have you seen the video?
Nitrogen-made ice cream.
Yeah, it's like smoky, isn't it?
Smoky ice cream.
Smoky ice cream.
Can make any flavour there and then...
Probably... Lee's just rubbing everything he can do today. He's touching the side.
Fine.
I mean, he says it's coming July. You know, from coming on the monorail, it looks like it was about ready to go, to be honest. So we should see this opening soon. At the end of the day, it's summer.
It's August next month, so that's it. When August comes, it's nearly Scarefest, so, you know.
That's quite nice. I'm even rubbing this one now. So yeah, this is coming July, and it's July now, so it could open any time. Within the next... It looks ready from what you can see on the monorail through the boards. Looks ready to go.
Zombie smoking.
There you go.
It's going to look like that, but with ice cream.
Yeah, that's probably why they put it in. I'm sure it'll be an interesting addition, a bit of a surprise addition. But I'm sure next time we do a vlog later in the year, we'll give you a demonstration of Nitrogeni, magical ice cream.
I'm not tasting it.
You are?
I'm not.
He'll eat anything. What's your head there, Alex? When John Wardley designed this, he didn't think of Alex's head, did he?
Oh my. I'm back then, yeah. Hello, Emily.
Emily. Where are you, baby? She's gone to sleep. Oh, he's vibrating.
Hello.
Ooh, ooh. Hello. I'm known as Dr. X.
Spidey Spider?
You can call me Spider Monkey.
Oh, I like his hair, dude.
Hello.
His name's Lee Wood.
Are you excited for California? Because
yes.
I am.
Hang on.
It's
Six Flags Magic Mountain.
So hold on, it says push.
Are you going to buy one? How much are they?
Don't worry, folks, you are still watching Theme Park Worldwide on YouTube.
Oh, yeah, we're just looking at Teddy's. I like it. Okay, that's enough of the Teddy's. As soon as the toys are available.
Come on! Come on! Come on! Come on! Come on! Come on!
On a plane,
yeah, the
steaks on a train, runaway mine train.
Runaway mine, do you enjoy the mine train?
Hey!
Every shot we're going in, we're just playing with the toys today.
Put it around your neck. Put it around your neck and be like your hug buddy.
Oh,
look at that. Oh, hug buddy for me.
Yeah. Oh, I just can't wait to be hug buddy. Did you have a nice ride on the mine train?
Yeah.
I enjoyed the mine train, it was good. He's attacking me.
It's Lee, what, everybody?
Oh, Steve and Dave.
Oh, well, yeah. Steve and Dave.
Ooh, no money, mate.
Oh, I do apologise for this. One is a note from the mine train that's changed is quite recently. These guys. They've added choo choo onto the photo frames. It now says choo choo on the frames of the photo, which is quite good. You alright there? This is round. That's Dave, that one. Gorilla, 30 centimetre gorilla. £18 for Dave.
Compare the meerkat.com.
Simple. I do apologise how random this video is.
Hello, theme park worldwide. My name is Mr. Giraffe.
Mr.
Mayor Carnage on its neck. I don't know, I can't do the accent.
Mayor Totens.
Bye.
Buy your tokens for the next ride, it's fast.
No!
Oh dear. Dear. I'm going to turn this camera off before it gets any more random. Time for a ride on the Congo River Rapids now. Let me just go through a few of the ride restrictions. Obviously, no standard up. And this ride's not suitable for those with heart conditions. Expect some mothers and please. Most importantly, no babes in arms. Sorry, Charlotte. Oh! Extended. Oh. KFC. 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 Yes. And Alex is hit by the full force of the KFC mega wave. Oh, beautiful. KFC. KFC. Was that better? Oh, what a beautiful. Again, the reason why we call it KFC Mega Wave, for any of you that don't know, the building, what is now Explorer's Pizza and Pasta, used to be a Pizza Hut and a KFC. So that's always known as
KFC Mega Wave.
Oh, that's mate Lee Wet. Lee Wood, everybody. Enchanted Village.
So I told these guys that I've got a job working in the bowling alley. They said temporary. So I was like, no, it's a permanent job.
I didn't get it.
Oh.
Oh, yeah. Hey. Here we go, beautiful tunnel. Oh, Alex got a bit wet again.
Yeah. It's getting moist.
It's got a bit dark. Special shout out to Ruby Withers, who likes getting wet.
On the Wappids.
Wappids.
Ruby Withers, she likes getting moist. If you've not seen it, Chesterton vlog. We had a great day. KFC round two now on the Rapids.
Who's going to get it?
Who's going to get it? Lee Wood, I think. No. Nah, you want a bit, don't you, Lee?
No.
I've not seen you in that hoodie before.
Listen, you want.
Lee's actually wearing a jumper.
You don't see special.
New hoodie, here we go. KFC! Lee. KFC! KFC! Hey, 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 oh! Round number two, Alex Crump, everybody. Round number two of 10.
What?
So we had a nice trip in Katanga Canyon there. Mine train, three rides on the rapids where Alex got soaked.
Dragon Mountain.
For the third time as well. Yeah, Dragon Mountain. Yay. That vlog from Fantasy Island, one of the best ones here on the channel. It was cracking. I might have mentioned it in the last vlog, but in fact I did, showed you around the refurbished Mutiny Bay shop. It's now had its name changed to Shark Bait Reef Shop now. which is a bit more fitting as he does exit from Shark Bay Reef, the aquarium. There we go, good audio. But fancy looking shark bait. Do you want to go? Oh, that was a good photo of that from Lee Woods. We're going to have a little look in the new Lego shop in a minute as well. I'll show you guys that.
Let's go and see Baby Zena.
Baby Zena, rest in peace.
Opposite Hook-a-Dock. Hi guys.
Hiya. Today's events, Ocean Tank Talk, 11, 1, and 3. As you can tell, none of us know the time. That's why we left school when we couldn't do.
I'm still at school. College.
College, yeah. Education. He's not very good. I don't know why he bothers.
I'm quite intelligent. I've got 3 GCSEs. Wait, 6, 7.
A what? What's a GCSE? I'm joking, don't worry. Ooh, Tower of Terror.
Here comes the octopus time.
Hello. Let's go and sit on the octopus. There we go.
Fishy, fishy, fishy.
Oh, he's getting down on his knees. You know, it's a good photo from Lee when he gets down on his knees. Let's have a little look at the angle he's got there. I'm stealing your angle. That's the photo that Lee just got there. It's a movie action photo that I like to call video.
Oh. Missed. Oh, you got a fail from Lee over there?
Cod score. Yeah. Oh, giving her a little tickle there, Baby Zena. She's just chilling out. Just finished watching Jeremy Kyle.
Waiting for Loose Women.
Waiting for Loose Women. She's got a long wait.
Then Judge Rinder.
You enjoying that? Come on, come alive, baby. No.
Alan Titchmarsh in the afternoon.
Alan Titchmarsh.
Oh, I do really like Shark Bay Reef. I mean, yeah, it's another really nice attraction that sometimes, when you come that much, you always miss it. It's a really nice themed, immersive experience.
Sean's big knocker.
Hey, look at that. It's not quite as good as the one in Jewel. Yeah, it's not as good as the one in Jewel, Alex, that.
It's not even real.
It's not even real, it's fiberglass, isn't it? Yeah. But it's good theming. It doesn't have to be real to be good theming.
Snapper! Try and pronounce that there, Sean.
Luchanus Casmira, I think. I don't know. You enjoying that, Jack?
Personal treatment.
I'm obviously missing some stuff over here, so I'm just
going to...
Now I get it. That makes it a lot more
easy. You just doesn't like popcorn chicken.
I like popcorn chicken.
It's alright, isn't it? It's good on occasion.
I did, and then I became a veggie, so I
don't
eat it.
Oh, enjoying that there.
So nice.
So relaxing, and so beautiful. Oh, you got two of them back now.
Hey,
he's getting double his money now.
Two over there
are good. Just needs a girl to hold his hand now, he's sorted.
Oh,
I'm joking,
I'm
sorry. Sorry.
You can talk.
I can't talk, can I?
Alex is still freeing about the ladies.
Go on, get a third one.
He's gone.
John,
he's on.
Third top.
Number three.
Number three's on.
Look at that now. He's getting his annual pass money's worth this year. There we go. Yeah, it's a really nice themed experience, Shark Bay Reef. Like I say, a lot of people do miss it on a visit to Alton Towers, but it's well worth coming in. It's not the biggest sea life centre, but it's nice for what it is. And there's Lee taking a picture again. It's definitely one of the best themed sea life. All the lighting. I love lighting, stuff like this, I do love it. There we go. Hello, you're a bit more active. Oh, he's enjoying that. Look at that. Nom 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 nom. Give me some food. Nom 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 nom.
Oh, Shambhala.
Hello. Oh, you like Helix, don't you, eh? Hello, Chris.
Yeah.
There we go. Helix.
Big one. He likes the big one.
No.
He's having the broccoli.
Oh, he's enjoying that.
You think it's Falcon's Fury? He's that. Dropping down.
You know, Falcon's Fury. Are you going to be riding that?
I am.
Yeah. Yes. Alex is going to Orlando, aren't you, next week? So unfortunately, I'm not going with him. I wish I was going with him.
No, you don't.
I do. I'd like to come with you to Orlando.
Sit yourself in the suit that I can't see. Suitcase.
Yeah, can I come in your suitcase? Who are you flying with?
American Airlines.
I won't bother then.
Surely goes Virgin Atlantic.
Virgin Atlantic to Orlando only for me.
On the big Dreamliner, aren't you?
Look at that. What a beauty. You enjoy that, mate.
Nom nom nom.
It's a really nice combination of theming, audio, and lighting in here. God. It's not Halloween yet, Alex. Thanks for that. Alex Crump, everybody.
My God, you broke
it. Under the sea. Under the sea. Under the sea. I'm gonna swim. Look at Jack there, he's enjoying that.
Under the sea.
Oh, that's a cute one, that is.
Oh.
Time for Sean's speaker services. Fantastic speaker there. Great manufacturer is Tannoy in Uni Bay. Tannoy in Uni Bay speaker. To get this spinning like we've never spun before.
Ready?
I don't think all four of us have ever been on this together, have we?
Hey,
The good fish guide.
Let's have a look what we got in there.
Some cod, some tuna, some you shall be ruthless.
I want some cold water prawns, I think. Cod, haddock. Where the hell did you get this?
Shellbait ring.
And elephants and pandas are also fish. Rhino and pandas.
Oh, so elephants, oh dear, you're never going to live that down now. Alex called that an elephant.
We'll see, it was upside down, give me a chance.
It's a valid point.
You didn't get GCC, so you know, we're all cool.
Right.
You did really.
Good fish, guys.
Nice. Let's get this spinning. I don't think all four have ever been on this together before at the same time. All four experts in spinning this beauty. If you wonder what Barrel 5 is, I'll explain for the people that don't know. Hey, up, Theme Bar Worldwide on YouTube, guys. Yeah, Barrel 5 is basically a barrel with a number 5 on it.
And that's.
Where is she?
There.
Ah, there we go, Barrel 5. There you go, she spins better than anyone else. Here we go.
Here we go, Barrel 5. We're off.
Come on, keep turning the wheel. Going for a little look in the brand new for 2015 Treasure Trove Lego shop. These cams can blow at any time. The smoke effects in here, it's really quite nice.
Oh, there we go.
Nice shot. Oh, here we go. That so failed. Nice effects though, if you look at that. It's a nice shot. You got a nice flame effect up there.
Sean wants one of them.
From Maplin. 20 quid from Maplin. There we go.
Sure.
This is nice.
Sure. Sale price.
Sure. Welcome to Mutiny.
No, we're not having no more of this shop fun. Lego City.
You can't do more of it.
A nice theme light. Just a nice shot, really. It's better than a photo unit, what was here before.
Short one of Sean's up there.
That's Joe's
favourites.
It's quite a nice shot. You can buy Lego in this shop, believe it or not.
Spend over £10, get a pound.
You know that, Alex. You sell Lego in here.
Yeah, well.
Lego in the shop. What happens if you pull the rope? It's not that long, obviously.
No, it
drops.
It's like a scare maze.
Oh, wow. It's like the Towers box room. Let's rein out the moment. So I'm coming round the corner here. There we go. And that's Tower of the Towers. Will it be back this year? Who knows? Or will we see different stuff for Scarefest? We'll have an announcement soon, I'm sure. Certainly. Enjoying the shop there. Yeah, it's just a nice addition. Out of 10, I give it a good 10.
What does this remind you of here? What's this little set of reminder?
Nah, this reminds me of Lego, mate.
No, mate, it reminds me of Mez.
Ready? So put it in pocket first.
And draw.
Boom.
There we go, it's like we're in the old Wild West. Jurassic World. His ball nearly dropped. What do you reckon to Jurassic World as a film?
Good film. Great film. So many theme park references, really hilarious.
Yeah, the website's great, isn't it, Jack?
Yeah.
All the interactive like CCTV and stuff, isn't it?
Better than any other theme park website.
Yeah, it's good.
What have we got here? A little mini.
Double decker.
Smart car.
Double decker couch. That doesn't look...
Oh, that's the couch there,
look. Oh, I was going to say, that doesn't look like a couch to me, but not seeing that in the background. Yeah. Right. Should we get on the flume?
Here we go, we've got the swarm van here, look.
The swarm van. Just tip it on its side and you're sorted. Alright. Is everybody else up for flume?
Yeah,
let's do it.
Let's get wet. Wah, wah, wah.
Dun, dun, dun.
Looks like we're going to get wet. The squirters are on. Once the world's longest log flume. The flume, rethemed in 2004 at Alton Towers, is a classic, especially in the summer season. And I'm not complaining in July, having no queue.
It was the package along with Bubble Works as well.
Bubble Works, what a great ride.
It got rethemed to Imperial Leather.
It did, the big Imperial Leather sponsorship, and then now it's been taken out again.
Yeah, so the flume unplugged is now no more.
Back to the flume. I do like the theme of the flume. I think it was really good of the park to do a take on an old sort of classic log flume. Every park has the themes of log flumes, aren't they? What's your favourite log flume style attraction you're going to be on?
Favourite? I suppose...
Put him on the spot.
I suppose I have to say... Disney California's Splash Mountain, the original Splash
Mountain. So obviously I've not been on that yet. Jack's already been, but we're going to be riding it in 2 months.
It's the original Splash Mountain with the standard one behind the other boat.
Would you rate that higher than Splash Mountain at the Magic Kingdom?
Yeah.
There we go, you've heard it from Jack himself. He's got a lot to live up to now. Let's get on the flume. Looking forward to it, California.
Whack, whack. Oh, yeah, I've got this new little...
queue line. This is actually my first ride on the flume this year, I believe.
And mine as well.
So here we go, let's get wet. Quack, 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 quackity quack. Foamy bubbles.
Foamy bubbles.
Do-dum. Do-dum.
We're gonna need a bigger boat.
Having a really nice day at Alton Towers today. We're a bit wet now, aren't we?
Moist.
You're right there, Alex. Still single and wanting a lady. If you know anybody out there, he's a lovely guy. He's a really nice guy.
No way.
Really, really nice guy, Alex Crum. Yeah, I had a nice moist ride on there. The flume. You love it, really, Alex.
Alex is feeling moist.
Jack's single too.
Same for Jack.
I want to be single.
Whoa!
I don't want to
be single, actually. Thank you. Battle Galleon's a nice day for giving people a bit of a squirt later on. Are you a bit wet there, Lee? In your nice new hoodie? Yeah.
Super dry, too bad. I think so.
Super dry, yeah, super wet.
Yeah, let's go squirt, so see what I mean.
Let's have a little look at the guns, see if we can get some people. The weather's quite nice today.
Yeah. There's some people coming on battle galleons, so let's try and get them.
On the galleons, the mighty battle, opened in 2008 along with the rest of Mutiny Bay. Retheme of Merry England, which was getting quite a tired area. The rethemed area is a lot nicer than it used to be.
Obviously, it used to be the splash cart.
There used to be a pay extra attraction on here. Splash cart challenge, and previous to that,
the swans.
Yeah, the swans.
Which can now be found dotted all over the country.
There's one in Cheadle, isn't there?
Yeah, there's one in Cheadle.
Yeah. Cheadle, if you don't know, is quite local. Here you go, he's off. As you can tell, they're a bit excited. They've never been on battle galleons before. Here we go. Oh, here we go, he's gearing up, ready for the battle. Here we go. Oh, Jack's got a good gun there. Keep the water flowing. Here we go.
Oh, God, why did I do this?
Oh! Hey! No, Lee's bailed out. Everybody's bailing out. Come on, Alex, don't let him down. That's it. Go. What is going on with the guns? Nice. Oh, there you go. Rather you than me. That's it. Here we go. Next boat.
Hoodie is coming off.
What shirt has he got on? Plain blue?
Plain blue. With a nipple on the side.
I love how we're not going like...
You know, it's a quiet day at Alton Towers when the main connecting path between top end of the park and bottom end of the park is rather quiet. But it's nice, it's very peaceful around here.
You can hear dark forest audio from around here as well.
Yeah, it's very quiet for a Sunday, but it's beautiful. If you look down the gardens, it's a really nice time to go and see the gardens actually at the moment.
It's full bloom at the moment.
It's nice, yeah. Any time over the summer is really nice, but best time for your flowers between May and sort of now. If you look at that down there again.
For Alex, yeah. There you go.
That's the way to win Alex's heart. Hey! Mind your step. Alex, I thought you weren't going on a trip until next week. Them classic moments that you just can't repeat.
No, it was the thing. I was like, oh, I'm falling for you.
Oh, there you go.
Sean's magical.
I'm sure there's a single lady out there. All the single ladies, put your hands up for Alex Crump. You're not a single lady, Alex. I'd be worried if you were.
Truman.
Oh dear. Even the rocks get themed to oblivion here in X Factor. Back on the B&M Beauty, my last ride on a B&M dive coaster before riding Baron 1898.
It's going to feel weird to you when you ride that.
I can't wait to ride the brand new dive coaster at S Island. I've been waiting for that ride ever since it was announced. Thinking, I can't wait to ride it. Obviously, this was the prototype ride. Oblivion Alton Towers inspired Shikra, Griffin, all them dive coasters out there. You've got stuff like Crake, the more modern ones, Heidi Park, Oblivion the Black Hole. That is it. In sync there, Mr. Jack Gator. Oblivion the Black Hole, of course, at Gardenland, a fantastic ride. And as I've said this before in the Gardenland vlog, it's not very...
Postcode, everybody.
Hey, SD4. That is actually nearly my postcode. But there you go. As I was saying, Oblivion the Black Hole, it's not very often a new remake of a ride can actually beat the original. For me, Oblivion the Black Hole, you know, is a lot better than the original. And it's great that Merlin Entertainment have done that to the ride. It's not a copy of the original Oblivion, it's a follow-up to the story. And that's what I really appreciate about Oblivion the Black Hole. I really like to get these guys out there.
The best shot for this coaster.
What do you think, you two? Gardenland next year?
Yeah, we'll do it.
I think you'd really like Gardenland. I mean, Oblivion the Black Hole's great. Raptor, a great wing coaster. And some other really good classic rides there, like Sequoia Adventure.
It's
there you go, what a ride. Let's get on the B&M Beauty. Don't look down. Go the teddy bear. Come on.
Don't.
Oh, here we go.
Look down.
Do like the interactive shots, I must admit. Four-way air hockey table. You ready, boys? 50p each for this one. Sight you want to see whilst you're eating your tea. Oh God. Oh, come on, ride it fast. Come on. Come on, Grump. Ride the bull, ride the bull. Arcade now, after that randomness.
Who wants to win a fiver?
Please, having a nice rap. What are you doing? You're like a walrus. A walrus. Hey. So, you've had some nice lunch? You're right there, aren't you? Just with your tub of baked beans over there. Nice. We've had a lovely fried chicken.
What's this?
And I've been the cheapskate as always.
70p.
70p. Whole lamb squash. 70p lamb squash. Akanakanakanan. Yeah. Muffin.
Roast chicken crust.
Roast chicken. Add crunch to your lunch from Walkers. Other brands are available.
Other flavours too.
There we go. How's your wrap, Lee?
Right.
We like fried chicken at Alton Towers, it is nice. Unfortunately, due to insufficient funds, I have referred you to the lunchbox. Nah, I'm just trying to be tight. At the end of the day, it's my local park, I live just down the road, so I'll bring my lunchbox, saves me 5-6 quid, doesn't it? Put that towards the next Ryanair flight.
Just being a tight house,
like hey, I'm not like Steve and Dave. I just like saving me money for them Ryanair flights.
California.
Wow. California.
Beautiful. These are nice. What are they called?
Poppin' chicken.
Poppin' popcorn chicken.
Poppin' chicken.
Poppin' chicken. KFC rip-off. Mega wave. Hi, Lee.
My patch is bigger than yours. Go on, make that pie, I do go with the old trick.
That's it, end of the fight. Hey, fever. Beautiful town's ruins. Still an amazing centrepiece for the park. A lot of the theme park can say they've got a historic building right in the centre of it.
And don't say Disney, because that's a fake castle.
Can you tell us facts about the towers, Sean?
A few facts about the towers? Why, what facts do you want to know about the towers?
An interesting fact that the viewers might not know.
Okay, an interesting fact the viewers might not know is that this, Alton Towers itself, has been known as three different names over the years.
Alton Lodge, Alton Abbey, and Alton Towers.
Sean's interesting.
Here we go. How many chimneys are on Alton Towers?
A lot.
Are there light bulbs on Tower Street?
Are there light bulbs on Tower Street? I don't know. I don't know why even guy know all this stuff.
How many?
I don't have a clue. It's my first time here.
How
I
many
don't
working
know
light bulbs are there on Tower Street?
Two.
To be fair, four.
There we go. Let's go to our next ride. We're going to the Dark Forest, I think.
Yeah.
Dark Forest.
It's not very dark.
Not very dark. It's a sunny day.
If you go down,
oh, 0-0-0-0
today, yeah, might get sunburned, it's a bit warm.
0-13.
What are you having, Alex?
Ice cream.
A whippy. Look at all this money flowing out of that wallet there. Look at this. All them notes, all them £20 notes stashed up. Oh, that's a nicely topped whippy. Look at that. How much was that?
Nitro Genie, $8.99.
It's coming soon. July 2015.
Can you, someone hold me whippy?
I'll hold it.
Hold me whippy. Don't do that.
Mad.
Thank you. We stop it. Christ's sake.
Temporary hold up at the ice cream.
Nice, I might have to buy one.
Have come.
Stop it. That's mine.
Come on, all right, come you the ice cream bag now.
Enjoy. I freshly licked the bottom bit for you. There you go. Enjoy my saliva. Five-minute wait for a five-year-old ride. 13, the Demon of the Dark Forest. Great interim family coaster. I mean, there was a lot of hype surrounding this ride. We didn't know what it was going to be. I remember with Jack, actually, we stood here in what was Ugland at the time, wondering what was going to be built.
Must drop, we thought, because that space.
You know, me and Jack were actually guests. We thought it was going to drop somehow, didn't we? You know, and it was great watching this being built. It's one of them coasters where Alex casually having his ice cream in the background. It was one of them coasters where there was so much suspense surrounding it. Nobody really knew what was going to go on inside that show building. We knew it had pretty much a standard layout in the forest.
And then all the speculation came out with like a diagram or something of a train going in, then bouncing around a bit.
All sorts of different theories about what was going to happen in the building, and then opening day came, and with the GMTV report.
We all ran here with Jonathan Ross.
And what a great day that was. Alex Scrump, everybody. What a great day that was. And it's definitely lived up to be a really good ride. When it first opened in 2010, and obviously into about 2011 season, this coaster was one of them what was quite...
He looks a bit stuck there.
He does, yeah. We've had a bit of tree choppage going on. But people didn't rate it quite highly. Now it's rated as a really good family coaster, just what it should be all along. At the end of the day, make no bones about it, it is a family coaster, you know.
Also, they've fixed the Tesla in here as well.
Yeah, Tesla's back
on. Which hopefully we'll get.
I'll try and get some footage of you as we go through of Tesla for you. We do like a bit of Tes, don't we? Tes Daily.
Tes Daily.
Let's get on. 13.
Really nice soundtrack, really nice station. It just shows a nice experienced coaster. That's what I really do like, especially 13. It's a good one.
Link to the ride already.
What's that?
Just link to the ride already.
Yeah, what a ride.
Who's saying hi? Hey, Theme Bar Worldwide on YouTube. Check it out. If you dare. If you've made it, hello.
Welcome to the channel.
Alex is just tripping over me.
I'm just tripping over
me. That's the third time he's tripped up today. Let's get on Intamin Forest the ride. Tesla car's literally just gone off, but it does show that it is working, it's operational.
Really nice ride there on 13. What really made me happy there as well is that while we're in the queue, we saw a guy wearing a Shambhala t-shirt.
Hey, Shambhala.
You know, Shambhala. Not very often you see.
Go and sing Shambhala at the end of the
It's not very often that you see Shambhala merchandise in the UK, never mind at Alton Towers, so good to see. Good soundtrack. So it's a really good soundtrack.
You alright there?
Wait, hang on.
What's he doing? There we go.
Hey, there he is, that's the thing. Can we just see your t-shirt? Hey! 76 meters of extreme challenges, Shambhala everybody. There we go.
That was the end of We Love Shammy.
That's it, thank you very much, Shambhala the ride. As if he just came off as well, what a legend, what a guy, what a man, John everybody. We're off to see the brand new Ice Age 4D film. You might remember in our Alton Towers vlog from March where we actually thought that it had started from the start of the season. I think you were here for that, weren't you, Jack? And we were wrong.
Sean said something quite funny as well. He said, if it plays the same movie again, I'm walking out. He didn't, though. He's emotionally attached to it.
Well, it's actually, we have been to see it since. It's Lee's first time now about to watch this brand new film. Excited, Lee? You got your glasses? There we go.
How many of you guys
are
there?
Two.
Some more glasses
coming out. Yeah, this film's a lot better than the old one. It's not quite as long, and we'll give you a full review when we come out, see what Lee thinks of the new film.
Okay.
Much as glassy ass.
Enjoy the film.
Oh, there we go. We're a bit tangled.
Tangled.
Box of glasses.
Disney's tangled. Let's go. Oh, Lee, you look very attractive.
I'll put my glasses on now.
Oh, look at that.
Hang on, I'll give you a little... Oh, they can stick on.
Little demo. Hey!
You're in 3D. Oh. Sean's in 3D.
Let's go. You're looking forward to this, Denley.
Yeah.
What did you think to the old one?
Not too bad.
It was good. For the first time. It was a bit repetitive when you see it about 20,000 times.
Too right. Let's go. Magic photo with the Ice Age stars. We'll give you a full review when we come out of this beautiful air-conditioned theatre. Ice Age, no time for nuts.
Here we go.
Nuts. Do you want to build a snowman? Doesn't have to be a snowman.
Okay, bye. I've seen that photo.
Can you see the resemblance? Try and pull that pose. There you go, there you are. What do you think of the film, Lee?
Yeah, it's really good.
Yeah, it's nice, isn't it? Yeah. It's a lot more funny, some nice lighting in there, some nice DMX lighting, and it's a lot shorter as well, so you're not sat in there thinking, come on, it's about time we got back into the park. Really do enjoy that film a lot. How about you, Jack? You like
it? As always, it's a good show.
It's nice, a lot better than the old one, that. Beautiful hot day at Alton Towers today. It's a bit busier up this end of the park, actually.
Scrats out.
Scrats jumped out of the film. That's 5D now. Scrat's actually here with us. Twilling Toadstool, anyone?
Yeah.
Let's go for a spin.
Warm now.
Hot day. There are loads of characters to meet here at Alton Towers. There's security. How are you? He's not speaking now. Alex Crump. He is available to hire to be your bodyguard, bouncer, whatever you want him to be. He's currently working, what are you, the doorman of where? Which nightclub? Pink. Yeah, he's not speaking now, yeah, he's a bit shy of his new job. Jack's off, talking of work. Jack's off, aren't you?
I'm off.
Yeah,
He's gone. He's off to work.
That just shows how close I am.
You know, it's good when you come to your local park and come up for the morning and then just say, right, I'm off to work.
Yeah.
You know, so.
Jack's off to work. Both disc jockeys aren't going to be able to get on the horses themselves. So.
What was that then? Good.
Oh, there you go. But of course, Jack, you'll see Jack again soon in one of these videos. He'll be back. We'll get something planned. Jack's back in action, everybody.
Eventually.
Jack Gator, we'll see you later. But us three, we're going to go and watch the Pirates of Mutiny Bay kidnap of Lady Victoria Sponge.
2:30 showing.
2:30 showing. Done loads today, haven't we? Really good.
We've already done that the whole park, haven't we?
Yeah, pretty much done. You know, got loads in. Got some nice coaster shots for you. Just wanted to show you guys, really, coming here in the summer, really good time to come. Beautiful weather, it's a beautiful park in the sunshine. When the weather's like this, walking around, it's absolutely lush. Yeah, it did say that the storm is coming later, so we've made the most of it this morning. Let's go and watch the show. See you later, Jack.
Bye.
Adios, and Mr. Super Dry himself.
Which is already dry from the flume.
Super wet, let's go.
Kidnap of Lady Victoria Sponge.
Weather can change. Just before we watched that show, I was just saying how nice it is to be here at Alton Towers in the sunshine. And
hey,
cast of the fantastic Pirates of Mutiny Bay. Oh. You're nearly there. Come on, you can do it. Yeah, the weather can change like that at Alton Towers. Jumper's on, I think. Here it comes.
Welcome to
England. That's it, and Alex is in the lake. I can't believe this weather, it's Lee's fault. Lee said this was coming. The big bell. Going on Hex, one of my favourite dark rides. Get out of the rain, Alex is there with his shorts on. And your sandals. Lovely weather. Pirate show is really good though. I do love the pirate show. Would love to see more entertainment in the UK parks.
Are you glad that you did the flume and the rapids this morning then?
I am. You wouldn't think we were doing three re-rides on the rapids earlier, would you? It was really hot though earlier. It's got to be about 19 odd degrees earlier.
And the sun was
sitting in the show, watching the show then.
It was, and then it turned, didn't it, Lee?
It just came.
We won't be getting that in California, hopefully.
To watching Lady Victoria's Sponge.
It'll be getting worse.
See the turn in the weather, how quickly it goes.
That was literally straight after the show. Right, let's go on X. See you after. X. Again, we're very, very lucky to be able to have such an amazing high quality dark ride here at Alton Towers. Again, when you go to all these different parks across the world, sometimes it takes a minute to appreciate, you know, what we do have here. This, Hex, a fantastic dark ride. Obviously, you know, I absolutely love it. It's just fantastic. The Coma Madhouse. Do you guys enjoy Hex?
We were just saying, you know, we all love complete experiences. Yes, we love a good roller coaster, but a complete experience is more what I'm into now. I like the whole package, and that's exactly what you get with Hex. It's a whole package ride, you know, and obviously you saw a lot of the towers get restored for that ride.
It's very independent from the rest of the park, isn't it? Hex is very independent, you know, it doesn't sort of follow suit from the rest of the rides and attractions on the park.
It's
very
nice, and it sort of shows a nice bit of history. Oh, at least it stopped raining. Hey, there we go. And it brings you out to the beautiful towers and conservatories. Obviously, if it wasn't for this building here, we wouldn't be stood here today. You know, it's a beautiful ride. I think it really appreciates the history. It still amazes me, though, how, you know, how well it's been done to make you feel like you're actually coming out of the towers. And there's actually the massive warehouse just round about there. Towers are now closed. Preparation for Scarefest already. You can see some of the walls and things like that down there. As we come towards the end of our day here at Alton Towers, Scarefest is coming. Wonder what it's going to bring this year. Of course, we'll let you know here on Theme Park Worldwide. Please drag me on the front row, Rita.
Go, go, go.
This or Cannon, at least big. He asked me this question just.
This.
This? The wonderful Rita. Currently with how long a queue? Walk on queue. So we decided to do the front row. Well, Lee forced me into it. But I don't mind, one of our last days. Where's Alex? He's over there drinking milk. See him? There he is, drinking the old milk. Milk! Well, let's get on one of our last rides of the day here at Alton Towers. Really good day today. We've done well with the weather as well.
And Brooke, he's a hero.
Come on,
gonna
get
take pollution down to zero. We've been roller coaster information.
Yes.
Soon gonna be living in a mansion.
Theme Park Worldwide, everybody.
Take care, Nemesis. See you soon.
Hey. We're gonna be currently famous on YouTube now. What's up? Now we get to a dramatic walk away.
So I had a really, really good day today at Alton Towers. It's been nice to get back on the park. Like I say, you know, it's been a bit of a difficult time for Alton Towers lately, so it's been great to get back here, get on some fantastic rides, and it's just generally been a nice day on the park, apart from the 20 minutes where it absolutely chucked it down. It's been lovely. We're just at the wonderful new 2015 Enchanted Village, which is beautiful. It's really nice and relaxing, really chilled out. Obviously, Jack went earlier, so we won't know Jack's highlight, but what was your highlight of today, Alex?
My highlight of the day? I always don't know what to say. What was my highlight of the day, Lee? Come on, tell me.
Well, mine would be front row on Nemi.
Yeah, I think Nemesis. Getting back on Nemesis, having a good few rides on Nemesis today. Is that a mutual decision?
I think just the general enjoyment we've had.
We've had a good laugh today. It's been some funny moments. Yeah, Pirate Show was good.
You've enjoyed the fun in the shop.
The air hockey, yeah.
That's my favourite.
Yeah, it's always hard to do a highlight of the day, but like I say, I think living 7 miles away myself from Alton Towers, sometimes we go to all these parks and then don't really get to appreciate it sometimes as much as we should do. And we are very lucky to have the country's number one theme park just up the road, and it's a beautiful place. I've had a good day. See you soon, Lee.
Yeah, you'll see me. The Europa Park.
Probably. Europa Park, yeah, I'm sure I'll see you before then.
And you might see me for some Orlando updates.
Yeah, Alex is going to be doing a few Orlando updates, and he's going to be doing a little segment for the show for you in the next couple of weeks as well, I believe, aren't you? Yes,
there's the Welsh Weekender.
We're going to Oakwood, it's going to be good.
We're going to live stream from Orlando.
Yeah, so, yeah, well, we're saying live stream, but yeah, he's going to do a nice little segment for you for the shows. I won't give you the exact show, but it'll be over the next couple of weeks, so that'll be nice, something to look forward to from Alex, so thanks for that. That's it then. Now you've enjoyed it from Alton Towers. Plenty more vlogs coming up, including this weekend going over to Eftel into the Netherlands to ride Baron Akenaken, or 1898. What are you laughing at, Mr. Leewood? That's it.
You say it.
You enjoy your drink, and that means it's time to...
I'll see you in
Kudos credits.
See you in Wales. See you with the sheep. Kudos credits. See you later, guys.
Leewood, everybody.
Alex Crumb.
Missing you all.